Well, hey, this is Sean from the Prepared Homestead, and I'm here with Mike with Tactical Woodgoss. Mike, thanks for being with us today.
Oh, happy to be here.
Awesome. Well, I tell you what, we're here with the battery bank, and we're going to be talking about this, some of the capabilities and limitations, but why did you come up with the battery bank? Why did you put all these components together for customers?
Okay, so we initially, my brother-in-law and I initially did this for our wives. We both worked remote. We had big freezers full of, you know, meat that we had processed ourselves, and it would be a crime and a sin to allow that stuff to spoil,
right,
as much work as we put into it. And neither one of our wives liked the idea of pulling on a pull cord for getting a generator started.
Okay.
So we figured the easiest thing to do is put together a battery bank where they go down and unplug from the wall, plug into this, hit the button, and off they go, and not worry about that for, a while. And we added extra battery in parallel to it, and that allowed us to have time to get home and deal with things if the power went out for, more than a few days.
Awesome. Well, one of the things I really appreciate about this is it's plug and play. I mean, you've taken the mystery out of electronics and electricity and put it together for us, and so that you're exactly right. It is plug and play. Now, let's talk about some of the capabilities and limitations and kind of just walk us through it real quick.
All right. So the capabilities, it's got several outputs. The main output is the inverter. It's got 215-volt AC outputs, and you switch it into the up position on the connector there. And what it'll do is it'll give you a modified sine wave at 800 watts average, and then it'll peak out to 1600 watts for a short amount of time. And that's useful for getting a compressor motor started on a refrigerator and
okay,
or a skill saw or something like that. The big thing is you've got to stay within the 800 watts of average power, and you've got to stay within 1600 watts of that startup surge.
Okay.
So that's one thing. The other thing is we've got two 2.1 amp USB outputs, so that's useful for charging your tablet, your phone, that sort of a thing.
Okay.
And then the addition on this side here, we've got a 12-volt output, so it's directly connected to the battery. So this is a Anderson power pole for those in the ham radio community and others.
Okay.
That type of connector is very common, and that's up to 30 amps is what they rate it for.
Okay.
And we put big heavy wires on there, so.
Okay. Now you've got this three-position switch. There's off, and then there's up and down. And you said the up position basically engages the inverter.
Inverter plus USB.
Plus USB, okay.
And then when you turn it to the down position, that gives you just USB.
Okay, and so what does that do for you?
That makes your battery last longer.
Okay.
There's no sense making the AC voltage if you're not using it.
Because you're dropping power basically as you convert it.
Yes.
Right? Okay. So if you are just charging the phone or something like that, you can just put it in the down position and make this thing last a really long time.
Yeah. The amount of iPhone charges that you would get before you ran out of power on this thing, you may get 2 years of phone use.
Right. And that's really valuable. And that's, we're obviously hooked up to, we're charging off the grid right now. Mm-hmm. What are some other ways that we can top this thing off?
Sure. So on the opposite side from the 12-volt output is a 12 to 24-volt input. And this is the same kind of Anderson power pole connector. And what you connect to that is solar panels. So you can, the right size for this type of a unit with this 7-amp solar charge controller is about 100 watt of solar. That's just the right size for a single battery system like this. But we provide additional connectors here, and this connector has a couple of things. One thing is, Anderson power poles are very common through the industry, but not everyone has those. A lot of them use a different type of gendered connector here.
Okay.
So we provide this one, which a lot of cell phone manufacturers use. So you can plug it into that directly. And then the other thing is a cigarette lighter adapter. So this plug, you plug it into your socket in your car, and what it'll do is keep the thing topped off. That's useful if you're in a position where you want to have this in the trunk and available for deployment, and you just want it to be charged all the time. The 7 amps will keep the current from your alternator very low, but it'll always be ready when you need it.
Awesome. Well, I tell you what, two quick stories.
Sure.
First one is when we first got this, we were setting it up, I was really excited. We were having people over for dinner. We lost power. Now, normally when you lose power, you cancel with guests. And we're like, we don't need to cancel it. We have some other means as well. But this really helped us out. And my wife was like, well, I still want to use my rice cooker. Mm-hmm. So we were able to use the rice cooker off just the battery bank and basically have a full meal just like normal. So that's it was really cool. The second one was I do a lot of wood processing, and I'm working either for clients or doing my own processing, bringing in wood for the winter. Mm-hmm. And normally I am limited by the chains on my chainsaw. Okay, as far as like I have got three of them and I sharpen them here at home, and I take it out to the field, and when it gets dull, I replace it, and then I'm done. That's my limiting factor. I took this out with me, and I was able to sharpen chainsaws in the field and extend my time, and therefore reducing the amount of trips out there and everything else. Really sure. Cool. So I'm excited about this product. I think it's wonderful. It's great.
Yeah, it's amazing. A little bit of power, when there isn't any, can solve so many problems for you.
Right, and you were mentioning the other day when we talked, how if the power goes out and you want to settle the kids, sometimes maybe putting them in front of the TV to watch a show or something like that can be just the thing to kind of normalize things until you can stabilize and think, give you some space.
Yeah.
Excellent. All right. Thank you very much.
Yeah.